Hey guys, welcome back to Ricky Squirrel Saw. Today I wanted to try out another intarsia pattern. I've done one before of a mountain lion, but I've learned a few mistakes from what I've done, and I'm going to try again with this little rose. Alright, let's get started.
Tonight, you can hurt yourself trying to hold on to what you used to be. I'm so glad the past is all gone. Being out.
Guys, I just got off the saw, so I got all the pieces all separated now. So the next step is to sand them over and round them all the edges over. So to do that, I'm going to be using this little hand sander and my Dremel, which is in this box. So I'll be attaching a sander bit to this and then sand all the little fine details. So let's get into that. So I'm just going to use the hand sander to give it a quick surface finish. I'll do that for all the pieces and then I'll get the camera back on and I'll show you how I use the Dremel. Alright guys, for the next part, I'm going to be using the Dremel. We're going to be rounding off all these little edges and all the pieces. Alright, so I'm gonna turn the camera off and I'll finish up sanding everything. And I'll show you after.
There we go, I got it all sanded down. All the pieces are rounded over. The next step would be to start staining it. I'm gonna probably do that tomorrow. I'm gonna choose the stain colors and then I'll do that. So yeah.
Alrighty, so for the staining of the pieces, I'm going to be using three different stains: light, medium, and dark. So for the light ones, I'm going to be using Golden Oak by Minwax. For medium, I will be using Gunstock by Minwax. And for dark, I'll be using some Smoked Paprika by Kabot. I don't know how to pronounce that, but yeah. So I'm going to start doing that. Let's get on that. So to stir the stains, you don't want to shake the can because then you'll get bubbles. and you don't want that, so you just want to stir it in like a figure eight. Not too fast. But make sure you get all the stuff that's stuck at the bottom. So I'll be applying a few coats of stain to each piece, but so this is the first coat, obviously, but. I'm not going to stain the back of them because I'm just going to put a backer on the piece, so I don't need to stain that. Alright, so that's all the light pieces. Let's put the cap back on this. To the medium. Alrighty, so there's only three pieces for the dark, so that will go a bit faster. So that's the first layer of stains all on. Took all the pieces. I know you probably can't see that right because of all of the shadows, but I'll be back tomorrow for their second coat. So yeah, see you guys then. So hey guys, I'm back in the shop. I've applied another coat of stain and one layer of shellac. The next step to finish the pieces would be to sand off a little thin layer of the shellac because it leaves quite a rough finish on the pieces. But then after that, we're going to be applying just some clear gloss to the pieces. So yeah, let's get to that. Alright, so now that that's done, I'm just going to be wiping all the sawdust off, probably with the vacuum over there, and then we will apply some of the clear gloss. So yeah, let's get to it. So for the clear gloss, we're just gonna stir the can like we did for all the other stains, and then we're just gonna paint it on. You wanna get nice even coats with this, because this is gonna be the final gloss. Alright guys, so that's the final product. Very happy with this project. Thank you for watching. Please like, rate, and subscribe. Alright, see you guys next time.